come to La Isla Bonita, that all of our taxes, the amount of money that this community pays, what we're getting, dead children, abused women, abused community, because when they abuse a child, they abuse us.
Could 13-year-old Faye Lin Cannon still be alive today? The San Pedro community believes so. The teenager was found dead in her room at her family home, and her adopted parents are the suspects, after medical tests show that the child was physically and sexually abused. Today, residents staged a peaceful protest in front of the police station. They say the system failed Faye Lin.
I saw it, and many people saw it.
Did you ever report it?
I called the American embassy, and they told me that they were going to come, and they never came.
This is 3.5 years ago.
3.5 years ago. I called the human service from San Pedro, and he never came.
Do you feel that the system failed this child?
The system has failed the entire community, because this is not the only child. The abuse and the incest in this community is out of control. We want no mercy for these people, but I condemn the authorities for not doing anything.
I had reported this case 3.5 years.
You personally reported
it? I personally.
To whom?
To Mr. Adam Kay.
Who is Mr. Adam?
The social worker from San Pedro, ma'am. I always go to his place, and I never get a response. I'm sorry. I don't care where this thing hit.
What did he say when you reported the...
He did went. He went to see it because I was behind it. And he came back and he said everything is okay. The kids said everything is okay. The beds are clean. The house is clean. Everything is okay.
So you believe the social worker out here is not doing his job, is ineffective?
He's not doing it. He is not affected. And everybody could confirm that. They go to the office and they do not find him. He need to get his acts together.
I was neighbors for them for about 2 years. The saddest part, all the concern here is that at least 20 people went to social services to report this. Ms. Susana Ini twice took them. So I don't, it breaks my heart to think that these kids, every day I saw them going to school and not knowing the pain that was that they were going through, right?
Faye Lin and her three sisters lived in San Pedro with the Doehms. The girls attended this school, La Isla Bonita. Only the eldest completed primary education. Two of them were taken out of school, whilst only the youngest remained in school. Faye Lin was taken out about 3 years ago. In September, she'd be going into Standard 6. She completed Standard 3 with good grades, and so today the school mourns her passing. There were little signs that something was wrong, but her past teachers never suspected it was so serious.
I had an incident with Faye in class. One day, I told her that I would call her dad in because she was misbehaving. So when I did that, there was an aggressiveness that came out from her, very aggressive. She even bit my hand, and I told her, let's go, I'll take you in the office and I will call your dad. I insist, and she insists not to leave the class. Then there, I say, okay, I'll not call your dad, but what's the problem? And there, when I basically call Miss Addy, I tell Miss Addy, that we call your parent in, and basically we call him in, and they just deny everything from us. Everything. And that's the last incident I have. So I don't know, because of that incident that I had there, and she was already spoken out. So I don't know if that was why they took her out from school.
What was she saying?
She was basically telling me that she hate her dad with aggressiveness. Very, very aggressive. She cried.
Do you think if the community, if the people around had done more, Faye would still be alive today?
I'll say yes. I'll say yes, because Faye was speaking out already. Mm-hmm. She was. But then we couldn't do nothing, because then basically she stopped school. Even we ourselves asked why she stopped school. Mm-hmm. Even we as a teacher, even me, start to investigate if she was actually doing homeschool. Mm-hmm. So we can actually report it, but we couldn't find nothing.
Do you have any regrets as her teacher that you didn't see more, that there was more behind you know, that face that she put on?
Well, ma'am, I really feel hurted. I feel like I could do something, but I try my best.
There had been several allegations about them being treated wrongly. We never wanted to interfere with their business, but some people in the community did do something about it, and nobody paid them no mind to them.
So why didn't you guys as the school maybe try to intervene? This is a child.
Yeah, that's true. We never intervened because we thought that the authorities were going to take care of it.
Do you feel any sort of maybe a regret that you guys didn't do more?
Definitely, I really feel bad for Faye. She was a nice little girl.
In terms of the parents, as the principal of the school, did you have any interaction with the parents? What were they like?
Basically, no, because they didn't really come to the school for anything, or they would just call or text me if the girls were okay, and that was basically it. No, I never talked to them or anything like that.
Residents say that outside of school, the way the girls were treated by their parents was inhumane.
We saw it in front of their business. They never allow the children to go inside. The son is hot hair, and these are the children. And if they lean, they are watching them from inside. This is how the kids were. The kids, they get tired of this foot, they put the other foot. When the son is here, they go under the tongue board office. For the same thing, four kids. And when it was lunchtime, she went and bought four packs of bread and water and sat them on the beach on a log and gave them that to eat. And when they got upset, when the children did not want to obey them, they would cut their hair way up here like man, because they're little Indonesian or little Chinese kids. The woman told me that she picked them out of the garbage, and now she disposed one.
But as expats, residents say that the parents never integrated like others. And while the parents alleged that Faye Lin was mentally ill, just about everyone refuted that claim. Today, San Pedranos say the parents should be jailed.
I want them to send to jail and throw away that key. Rot in jail. Rot in jail. And let them feel what it is to feel when you're raped. Let them feel it. Because it's not fair. It's not fair. A 13-year-old you've been abusing. The way she died. We could have stopped it. We could have stopped it.
Did anyone from the community ever approach the parents and talk to them about what was happening?
Those parents, they were never a social person. They always mad. They only look on one side, and that's the way they were growing the kids.
So they didn't integrate in the community?
Never, never.
The parents have made allegations that Faye was mentally ill. What would you say to that?
Well, I think those allegations are wrong.
From your child, did you ever hear that this child was mentally ill? Did she display any of that in the class?
None at all. Parents are psychopaths, obviously. They're definitely lying. She's a smart little girl, first in her class.
How do you process this kind of news happening right in your community?
I'm just angry. I don't know how to process it. And it doesn't make sense. I'm just really angry. And heartbroken.
Reporting for News 5, I'm Andrea Polanco.